In today's video, I'm going to show you how to create a drop-down list. Now, why would you want to use a drop-down list? For example, if you have a column in which you want the user to enter either yes or no, the following might occur. Users might type a space behind the text yes. Users may type a space before the text yes. And sometimes users might use capital letters. And this all results in these texts not to be equal. This causes problems when using these texts in formulas, or for example, sorting these columns or filtering on these columns. To prevent these problems from happening, you may want to use drop-down lists. I'm going to delete these texts, delete on my keyboard. And now I'm going to create a very basic drop-down list. Select all these cells, click data validation, in the tab settings, click list, and as a source, I'm going to type the text yes, comma, no. Click OK, and now all these cells have a drop-down list. Yes, no, and if I want to type something different, for example, don't know, enter. I get an error message and I have to try again. For the column city, I want to do something similar. But this time I don't want to type a list of cities. I have a list of cities in another worksheet. So now I'm going to create a drop-down list, which uses the cities on my other worksheet. I could select all these cells and create a drop-down list for all these cells. But what I'm going to do now is create a drop-down list for this cell only, and then I'm going to drag this cell down. Select C2, and in the data ribbon, again, click data validation, click list, click the input field for the source. But instead of typing all these cities, I'm going to the cities worksheet and select all the cities. And this time I get a reference to the list of cities. Click OK, place the cursor on the bottom right corner and drag down. And now I can select a city from the list. And if I want to type a city name which is not in the list, enter, I again get this error message and I have to try again. The way I created these drop-down lists has one major disadvantage. If I go to the list of cities and I type a new city, for example, New York, you want New York to appear in these drop-down lists, but it doesn't. For new cities to appear in these drop-down lists, you have to take a few extra steps. I'm going to delete these drop-down lists, click Home, then here Clear All. Clear All not only deletes the cities I had chosen, but also deletes the drop-down lists. I'm going to create a new drop-down list, but this time I want the list to grow as the list of cities grows. In order to do this, I have to make this list into a table and give this list a name. Select all these cities, drag down one row and give it a title, for example, city. Select all the cities, including the title. Go to the Home ribbon and format as a table. And choose a format, but the colors and lines don't really matter. I'll choose a simple one, put a check mark next to my table has headers, and then click OK. And the reason I did this is not the formatting, but the fact that this table now has a name and I can refer to this table by its name and column name. Unfortunately, I cannot refer a drop-down list to a table name. I can, however, refer a drop-down list to a variable and have a variable refer to this table. So what I'm going to do now is create a variable which refers to this table. Go to formulas, click define name, type a name for your variable, for example, city list, and then as a reference, select all the city names. Now the variable I created is called city list and it refers to the entire column city of my table, which is called table 1. Click OK. And now I can create a drop-down list. select the cell for the first drop-down list, click Data, click Data Validation, click List, and now here in the source type equals city list. And city list is the name of my variable, and the variable refers to the list of cities. Click OK, and then again, copy this one down. Now I can choose a city from the list, but more important, if I type an extra city in this list, for example, Athens, then Athens must appear in my list of cities. And you see here, my drop-down list has changed. Athens now appears in the list. And these are three ways to create a drop-down list in Excel.